Hey guys, I'm gonna be streaming for a little while. I'm gonna be playing some Tanzia today. I haven't played it yet, so don't know what it entails just yet, but it's an adventure RPG, and it's currently in beta, so let's go ahead and check it out.
In the cradle of the New World, the island of Tanzia is home to a new and great race called the Akazi. The Akazi had little interest in technology and material wealth. They pursued wisdom above all else. With the Akazi, arcanity, alchemy, and endless possibility would flourish. Because of their unique values, other races often regarded them as primitive and mistook them for weak. A critical mistake. Life was good on Tanzia, until one day, a terrible evil known as the Skeleton King came to claim the island. The greatest Akazi warriors confronted the Skeleton King and his undead armies, and one by one, the Akazi fell. This terrible evil fought with an advantage, a unique knowledge of something born of this new world. This enemy fought with arcanity. The new world was young, and few understood the mysteries of arcanity. But one Akazi had already attained a mastery greater than any other, and the Skeleton King soon met his match. The Skeleton King was furious. This small, frail creature had undone decades of preparation with a single blow. The Skeleton King retreated, and the Akazi did not pursue. Tanzia was safe once again. The Akazi continued to flourish, and the Great One continued to pioneer alchemy and arcanity. Creatures of all races came from all over the world seeking his mentorship, and he taught any who would learn from him. Until one day, something more pressing demanded his attention. The Great One was blessed with many children and many grandchildren whom he loved dearly. But this one was very special. This one would be the center of his world for many years. As the child grew, he showed great aptitude for arcanity. No grandparent ever felt more love or pride for a child than the Great One did for his young grandson. But he knew that their precious time together would be short. The Skeleton King was already plotting a terrible revenge against his new foe. He would end the Great One's bloodline. The Skeleton King used the darkest of arcanity to summon an evil and tortured creature from another dimension and enslave it to his will. The creature, a shade, was the perfect assassin. It passed through solid objects at will, traveled nearly unseen in the shadows, and had a deadly touch. The Skeleton King watched from afar in glee as the shade passed through the young child and stopped his heart. With a single word, the Great One obliterated the shade into a million dark splinters that dissipated in the light. But the damage was already done. As the Great One fell to his knees, weeping over the body of his young grandson, the Skeleton King was very, very pleased. But The Skeleton King had once again underestimated his Akazi foe, and when the Great One sensed that the Skeleton King was no longer watching, the illusion was lifted, and the child was smiling once again. The Great One, though, was very sad, for he knew that events had been set into motion which would end their happy time together, and he would not see his beloved grandson again for a very long time. He sent the child to live in seclusion on Volcano Island with a most caring and trusted friend, Abenaki, far away from the peering eyes of the Skeleton King. The Great One, believing his presence was a danger to the village, also left. And he never returned. Decades passed. In the village, whispers of his sudden disappearance so long ago turned into speculation of his certain demise. The Skeleton King, believing that victory finally lay within his grasp, would again descend on Tanzia to claim his prize. And this time, no one can stop him.
So that was a really nice intro. I liked it a lot, but it did seem a bit long. However, I enjoyed it. Interaction stuff. Quest journal. Okay. Aww. He's so cute. Whoa. Look at the flips. Talent. Okay. So, quest. Stuff. Alright, gear up. Master Shaman Abenaki. This is such a cute little village. Are you Abenaki? Happy birthday, Maeka. I promised your grandfather I'd protect you, but I have to accept that today you are an adult. I will let you leave the village alone soon. Okay then. But first, with your new freedom comes new responsibility. It is time to perform the annual ritual of the totems to replenish the totems that shield the village from the forbidden art of voodoo. I need your help preparing for it. You'll need a weapon, a spell, and a potion. First the weapon. First one, gold. Go buy a precious staff, then return to me. Ah, you gave me a gold. You're momentarily overcome by a sudden wave of images and thoughts. That it had voiceovers though. You quickly recover and find your bearings, though the vision seemed to last longer. Scarcely an instant has passed. A sense of well-being washes over you and you feel energized and refreshed. Yay! 0 HP and 0 mana. Okay. So, there's a map. You can drag, zoom in. Gotcha. So that's where I need to go. Except I don't think there is there a compass? I don't see a compass. Totems! Replenish your hope and mana and a save point. Alright. So, do I just click it? Or is it automatic? This way. It's over here. Okay. character stuff. Woohoo! Yeah. So now, I have to go back there. Yes, it is very beautiful. Ooh, is there mining in this game? Oh my gosh. You can mine. Stuff to get you started, and our Kennedy found the trader and learned a short spell from him. Oh, I got 2 gold that time. If he's in here, it's down this way. Hey there! Very stiff. Yeah. She's very stiff. Oh, thanks for the follow, Kinderman Corp. I appreciate it. Need to talk to you. Yes. You only have enough gold for Ice Shard. Alright, let's buy it. It has been bought. Ooh. I like it's a dude walking around. Hi. And a shop. Do not be reckless, you are not yet one of the heroes from our stories. Its power continues to wane until we perform the ritual, but the big totem in the center of the village will still restore your health and energy when not in combat. Sounds good. When you're away from the village, look for smaller totems and stay close to them when you need to rest. I mark them on your map for you. First chore is to collect Akiri feathers. We'll need quite a lot of them for the ritual. Search for Akiri birds here in the village and bring me 20 feathers. It's okay if they're a little bit charred. That's funny. Another vision. Okay.
Thank you.
sisters will help their friends. Ha! Owned. Oh, Pekka, thanks for the follow. Slowed by a shard. So basically, that means I'm close enough. Gotcha. It's so cute! Not one shot. Oh, I have to click on those things. Okay. Whacking the birds. I wish there was like a loot all option though. It'd be nice to be able to loot everything. Buy fireball? Alright. I'll go buy fireball. I forgot where to buy it. That dude across from here, I think. No, that's the dude that gives me weapons. Yeah. That dude. That was nice. sweet star plant that the Akron turtles love to eat. That's by the beach, and the Akron never far from it. Okay, then. Be cautious, of course. Okay. I just love that. Hey, dude. Trying to get out? Yes. Then I'll get some potions. Do they stack? Okay. It's kind of cute that when I'm running and stuff, you can see him running in the icon as well. It's pretty cute. Yes. Let me go. Scissors can't follow you across its own border. So cute. Oh, hi there. Boom. Take that. What's this? Someone's camp. Dude, that hits hard. There we go. Alright, let's heal up real quick. Not to return the feathers. I need dangling underground for the crossroads. Okay. These things? Oh, it's like these things. Yep. Okay, then. I need to go to the beach. There's fall damage in this game. I think I'm gonna go down anyway, just in case. Don't wanna kill myself or anything. Aww, it's so pretty! It is nice. Okay. What's that? That looks cool. Cool. That's a portal. Sweet. So there are the turtles and then let's go shoot a turtle. Uh-huh. Oh, one mana though. Where's the thingy to loot? Oh, it's hidden. It's kind of hard to see the loot under the turtles though. It's a message in a bottle! Maybe. Nope. Ew. That's what I need. There's a lot of turtles. I have like no mana. I should have bought some potions. There, totem thingy. There. Let's go up for that totem. Go, go. There it is. Hello, dude. To fight on the run. Kiting. Have to kill a turtle without getting hit. Okay. Hello, person. There's so many of them though. I don't want to mess with the whole pack. Let's do this. Body somewhere. There it is. So did that count for my quest? Oh, only fireball. Whoopsies. Oh, not enough mana. Go heal up, and also I need to buy some mana potions. That turtle's still following me, is it? It sure is. Can they leash? feeling these guys don't leash. Well, I got him stuck. See if I switch zones. There we go. Maybe that'll work. Now let's go get some mana potions. There goes nothing. Just fireball. Oh, that was a nice crit. Woohoo. Three. Take three occurs down with a single shot. Okay. Not yet. This is really funny. Alright. There we go. Let's go back. More challenges. Challenges to get from here to Bucko's fishing hut and back without drawing attention. To be stealthy and quick. Oh gosh. So that's the hut. Okay. An invisible force strikes you? I guess I can't get across there. Ew. All right, so back. Not bad. Ultimate King. 9 to cure from here. Okay, all of them. Once. All 9. And 7. Oh, there's the others over there. Run. Target. Not enough mana. Just one left. Oh yeah. Now, let's loot all 9 turtles. I thought I was done with him. I still have to go there. Collect those. Turn those. Some crits. Many XP is good too. Cross that bridge. I'll try again, but I don't think they'll let me go over there yet. Check out that bridge. Yep, alright, I'm going back. I'll go turn in the quests. There's that port thingy there. Get the sea invisible recipe. And then go to the table to grab two sea invisible potion. Okay. Sweet invisibility. Can I buy the others? Actually, I only need one of them, but it must be pristine. We'll use this one and keep the extra. Alright, ready to go. We need lots of alchemy practice here. We need a cleanse potion. 4 silver and 2 crisp. There's some silver on this island. Probably the Emerald Village. Emerald Hostel is where it would be dangerous to travel there. I had some silver shipped from the big island. It should be at the docks by now. Alright. Silver from the dockmaster. We found the alchemy shop at the docks. Learned the cleanse recipe. Returned to me with the cleanse potion and performed the ritual. Okay. Sounds good to me. I might as well go kill some more things for XP too. Can have people. sucks. I wish I can store more mana. Bad monster, bad. That means I can now go across. Hopefully. That. Speeds up reaction time, that's cool. Take some. So pretty. I love the graphics. The dogs. I made it. That sucks. Missing image. There's no scene. I see some crabs. Oh, I can fight them. Whoa, buddy. Ah! Eek! I need more mana. Thank you. Roger. See if there's a way I can heal up real quick. Totem's way over there. At least these guys will give me good XP for a bit. Switch targets! Thank you. Thingy. Good. Sweet. So, that's the boat. To the boat. Not like that. So I'm gonna go heal up again. Sounds like I might have to clear through that place to get to the dock. Nothing. Ew. Oh boy. like I'm almost done in here. That they don't have the images for that stuff yet. I have one, and I know she left. Ouch. Okay, so I had to go lead some crabs back. This is how I had to do it. Oh boy. That's a good job. You said you can't hurt them. Yeah, I know, I wasn't going to. Just trying to get this dude to go around. There we go. Yeah, I'm just using the whistle. It doesn't hurt them. Oh, okay. Whistle, go! Go that way. This is pretty funny though, hurting crabs. Yeah, this is my first time playing, so I'm still figuring stuff out. There's usually better ways to do things than the obvious ones in this game. Looks like I can't swim. Come on, Krabby. You know you wanna. Having fun exploring in this game. I'm in no rush. You get a bonus for bringing two in a row, and the bonus is double each crab. Gotcha. He says you can't hurt them, but if you hurt them, they'll aggro you and chase you. Oh, okay. I see what you're saying. There we go. Oh, I guess they won't go around. All right. We go this way then. This is pretty funny, actually. Choo choo. Managed to stab me before he disappeared. That's pretty funny. But why can't I heal now, though? Looks like it still thinks I'm in combat. Wrong button. So I only need two more. I wonder if I can give him more than the 20. There's a bug where it doesn't clear aggro when you do the crafting that way. Yeah, that's fine. I'll just switch zones. Yeah, I'm gonna see if I can. When you zone, it'll get cleared, I think. Yep. Yeah, that's how I cleared it before. But that's okay. I'm gonna do the... It'll only be 20. Okay, I'll kill the leftover crabs then. This way. And then this way. That's cute. Thingy back here somewhere. There it is. works. New little setup though, looking fancy. Okay. So I have to go back to the village anyway. Alright, I'll go turn that in. Totally forgot I still had to turn it over there. Everything leads to over there now, it looks like. Oh. Alright, I'm actually gonna go ahead and stop right here. I have a few things I need to get done before the hubs gets off of work. But I'm really liking this game so far, it's really cute. I can't wait to play more. But yeah, thanks for watching and I will see you guys later.